How y'all doing? My name is Jonathan Mooney, and when I was growing up, I was what folks in my school politely referred to as one of those kids. Y'all know one of those kids, don't you? I was one of those kids who had such a hard time sitting still in elementary school that I grew up chilling out with the janitor in the hallway, right? I was one of those kids who had such a hard time keeping his mouth shut in middle school that I grew up on a first-name basis with Shirley, the receptionist, in the principal's office, right? And in high school, I was one of those kids who had such a hard time reading, and specifically a torturous time reading out loud, that I spent most of my high school experience hiding in the bathroom to escape reading out loud with tears streaming down my face. Like many of those kids, I had low expectations in my life. I was told when I was in sixth grade that I would be a high school dropout. I was told by a high school guidance counselor when I was in ninth grade that people like me end up flipping burgers for a living. And I was told by the same gentleman when I was 18 that I would be lucky to flip burgers because folks like me usually end up in jail. Now, it goes without saying that in my life, none of those very hopeful prophecies came to pass, right? Opposed to flipping burgers, I ended up a graduate of Brown University. I graduated away with an honors degree in English literature. Opposed to being incarcerated, I ended up the author of two books, the first I've wrote at the age of 21 years old. So I have done many, many things in my life, but I've never flipped burgers and I've never been incarcerated, right? Now, I raise that juxtaposition because when people hear about such a profound journey of change, everyone wants to know what is the thing that made a difference, you know? I'm asked by moms, I'm asked by dads, I'm asked by teachers, Jonathan, how'd you do it? How could you go from a sixth grade dropout who could not read at 12 to an Ivy League English major? What drugs did you take and where can I buy some, right? And the answer is that I didn't just do one thing to go on that journey of change. And those questions really indicate a predisposition in our culture to look for silver bullets or panaceas when it comes to changing the lives of young people, right? We're always out there trying to find the one thing that's gonna be making a difference. In our private sector investment, in philanthropy, we're always chasing the next silver bullet, right? We have what I call do-gooder ADD, right? One year it's out of school time that's gonna change the world. The next year, it's reading by third grade, right? And in the public sector, we have silos, right? We have folks who are looking at a tree and not the forest, you know? We got the education system that doesn't talk to the health system. We got the health system that doesn't talk to the transportation system and the well-being system. We got folks looking at one thing and not everything. But when it comes to changing kids' lives, when it comes to moving somebody on a journey of change, ask any parent what is the one thing they'll do for their kid, and they give you a funny look. Because the one thing they're going to do for their kid is everything, right? We all know that folks who go off to live successful lives have a continuum of intervention and a continuum of opportunity. They're not folks who just engage with one silo at one point, but the 21st century human development challenge is reconciling that dissonance, the dissonance of siloed investments to change lives and the reality that folks need a continuum of care. I believe to my core that the city can play an essential role in reconciling that dissonance, in solving that human development challenge. We all know that cities often sit in the middle of all those trees, right? They hold those trees together. We all know that cities sit in the middle of a vibrant public sector service landscape. Cities can create that integrated human development system. And they need to more than ever, as those siloed systems are underfunded or defunded. Now, as you look around the country and you look for models of cities that can create that integrated human development system, cradle to career, you don't got to look far, because Santa Monica has taken that challenge upon itself. I'm privileged to be a part of this cradle to career initiative here in Santa Monica. And the mission of this cradle to career initiative is to build that continuum of opportunity for every single child who is born and lives here. To achieve that mission, what we're doing is trying to build a new civic infrastructure, okay? And this civic infrastructure can be a model for other cities, other communities, and it consists of three foundational ideas. Number one, the cradle to career system is about collective impact. You all know in a time of diminished resources, we gotta make our dollars go further, right? We need folks working together, but if you look out at the nonprofit landscape, you often see folks with the left hand not talking to the right hand. You see folks working in a fragmented and uncoordinated way. Santa Monica is looking to change that. They're creating what's called collective impact collaboratives. Pretty simple idea. Get folks together in a room around key inflection points around the human development continuum. Early childhood, in and out of school time, family success and sustainability, as well as college and career readiness. Get the folks who care about those issues in the room, whether they're from city government, whether they're from the nonprofit community, and have those people develop shared outcomes, shared strategies, and shared common measurement, and then fund them to pursue collective impact. That's step one for us. Step number two is a shared data system. Y'all would be surprised, or maybe you wouldn't be, about how fragmented the data is out there about young people's development, right? But we all know that if you can't diagnose the problem, you can't solve the problem. And then if you don't know how to track the impact of your solutions, you can't change course. But so many of these systems don't diagnose the problem and don't track their solutions. Cradle to Career is changing that, right? In 2 weeks, we're gonna launch the first ever youth well-being report card in Santa Monica. It's gonna tell us how our kids are doing, where we're falling down, and how we can do better. In the months to follow, we're creating an integrated systemic data platform where service providers, whether they be city folks or school folks, can get real-time data on how a young person is doing in the moment. They can change course, they can target intervention. Stage three of Cradle to Career. Not only are we doing collective impact, not only are we sharing data, but lastly, we're looking to create shared policy, right? Y'all know Santa Monica has a plan for everything, don't you, right? They got a plan to build buildings, you know? They got a plan for economic development. Y'all know, for God's sakes, the city of Santa Monica has a master plan for the trees, right? Which they should, which is important. But we also need a master plan to build the human capital of this city, right? We need a master plan that's shared amongst the district, amongst the college, amongst the city agencies to make sure that we're not just building buildings and planting trees, but we're planting the foundation for human lives that can thrive. Now, embedded in this idea, right, is not only a plan to help those kids like me who hide in the bathroom, who don't do well in the school. Embedded in this plan is a new vision of what a city should be all about. You know, the city of the past has had its primary priorities be infrastructure, right? Making sure that the roads are taken care of, there's no potholes. Basic needs, making sure that the trash is picked up, and economic development, making sure there are jobs. Those are important, but the city of the future is going to prioritize not just those things, it's gonna prioritize the well-being of the human beings who live in this city. And it's gonna invest in that well-being. And it's gonna make sure that every single resident of Santa Monica, every single resident of LA, of any city, has an opportunity to thrive, cradle to career and beyond. Thank you all very much. I appreciate it.